Major news! MetaQuest VR headset is going to support Apple Spatial Video, aka MVHDVC codecs, natively without transcoding or sideloading. Ex-user M1 found codes inside the upcoming beta MetaQuest iPhone app, referring, watching, uploading, and even capturing spatial video with the MetaQuest 3 right here, so that they will show up in your movie folder on your Quest 3 headset using cloud computing. The regular non-pro iPhone 16 coming later this year is rumored to be able to capture 3D spatial video as well. MVHDVC will become the industry standard for 3D media, and you don't need to spend $5,000 on an Apple Vision Pro to watch or create them. If you still don't know what Apple Spatial Video or MVHDVC is, keep watching. At the time of recording, Apple Spatial Video or Apple MVHDVC video is just a fancy 3D video. Here is what it looked like inside the Apple Vision Pro. It does track your head a little bit to create a very subtle parallax effect. This effectively minimizes motion sickness when watching 3D video inside the headset. But don't get me wrong, this is not 6 degrees of freedom or volumetrics video. If you see the Apple Spatial Video inside Vision Pro, they are not 16:9, but in square format. So, to create those movement effects, my guess is Vision Pro use some kind of depth AI. For example, a similar application can be found in TikTok Depth Anything model to generate a low resolution depth map from 3D video. With this depth map at depth sensor inside the Vision Pro, the headset can block some of the capture based on viewer's movement. The end result is a very comfortable viewing experience. This is again my guess based on my 10 plus year in 3D filmmaking and volumetric capture research. I can answer more precisely when I have my Vision Pro on hand for a more in-depth testing. Since this is just a 3D video with an AI-generated depth map, not high-resolution LiDAR depth map like most people think, or at least not yet, Meta can use your iPhone 15 own powerful MVHDVC processor or decoder and their cloud computing magic to recreate the same effects you saw in Vision Pro. Or it can be even better with Meta, or to say Oculus, years of research in spatial computing. We don't know yet, but we are optimistic. Apple Vision Pro is great, however, it's not accessible to creators who are not in the US or don't have $5,000 to spend. We should not pay to create for free, and that is what Apple is trying to make us to do. I fell for it, but you don't have to. There are many other ways for you to become familiar in the spatial video creation pipeline, and now you don't even need to own an Apple Vision Pro to do it. In the long run, it is beneficial to Apple ecosystem as well. More content, more people will buy the headset. Everybody wins. What do you think? Comment below. If you are new to this channel and want to learn how to shoot, edit, and publish spatial video on Apple Vision Pro, make sure you subscribe and hit the notification bells for more. If you want to learn how to capture spatial video with your iPhone 15 Pro now, check out this video right here. If you want more alternative ways or cheaper way to watch spatial video like AR glasses, check out this tutorial right here. I will see you in my Apple Vision Pro official review very soon.